grim task of removing the dead. All on board, 44 perished. Wreckage was scattered over a wide area. Mute testimony to the horror that plunged out of a night sky.
The primary debris field was about approximately 6 square miles.
The distribution of the debris on the ground really conforms to that of an explosion in the air.
A lot of people described it as a firecracker-like smell that they could detect on the metal. The FBI forensic chemist determined that it had to be dynamite.
They also found bits of copper wire that were not part of the airplane.
Forty-four people died when United 629 exploded in the sky over Longmont, Colorado. Just 12 days later, the FBI got Jack Graham to talk.
The district attorney for Denver at that time made a decision that he would file a single charge of intentional and deliberate murder with Daisie King as the victim.
They found spools of copper wire similar to the wire that was recovered at the crash site. And they located a hardware store in the town of Kremlin, Colorado, and the owner of the hardware store, and he picked Graham out as the person he'd sold the dynamite to.
At the end, Jack Graham was found guilty of murder in the first degree. He was sentenced to death in a gas chamber.
He was executed in January of 1957, so only 14 months passed between the time of the crime and the resolution with the execution of Graham.